It's no big secret that when Windows 95 came along, it bundled MS-OS 7 underneath it, no longer requiring DOS to be separately installed.
This product is compatible with the vast majority of all the current hardware and software that's out there.
And while Microsoft did a lot to hide DOS away and making it an integral part of Windows itself, it's surprising to find that when upgrading from Windows 98 to Windows 2000, you're left with a hidden MS-DOS 7 folder on your hard drive. It's obsolete technology no one uses today, but I'll bring it back to life. I'm the Vintage Collector, and these are my stories. Over the years, many attempts have been made to extract the MS-DOS core from Windows 9X, especially as Microsoft never made MS-DOS 7 available as a separate product. Extracting MS-DOS 7 from Windows 9X is not too complex, as you can simply take the system files from the C drive. The DOS commands themselves hide in the C:\Windows\Command folder, and an additional set of files is to be found in the Windows install CD in the old MS-DOS directory. Although it would still refer to itself as Windows 95 or Windows 98, you'd then essentially have MS-DOS 7. At some point, an unofficial MS-DOS 7 distribution surfaced, which bundled the MS-DOS 7 core with some additional utilities and a nice installer onto a bootable CD. This unofficial bundle, mostly referred to as the CDU or China DOS Union distribution, is still available today on winworldpc.com and, as it had been patched accordingly, calls itself MS-DOS 7. But this is all fake, of course. Then I stumbled across something really interesting while doing another research, namely this old Microsoft Knowledge Base entry. It mentions that when upgrading from Windows 98 to Windows 2000, you'll end up with a new MS-DOS 7 folder after the upgrade.
Wait, what? An official way by Microsoft how to get MS-DOS 7?
It seems so. And I wasn't totally aware about this, even though I definitely had upgraded many systems to Windows 2000, I've never observed this myself, but more on that later. So I was pulling out one of my installed CDs and firing up VirtualBox to install Windows 98 for the sole purpose of upgrading it to Windows 2000. Now, it's as important that when you're upgrading to Windows 2000, you should choose to not convert the boot drive from FAT to NTFS. This is key, as MS-DOS can't boot off NTFS, and thus, you won't end up having MS-DOS 7 on your hard drive along with Windows 2000. And this is the reason I never saw this myself, as I never stuck with FAT32, but always converted to NTFS. Once the upgrade completed, fire up the Windows Explorer to inspect your C:\drive. You wouldn't see the MS-DOS 7 folder right away until you enable the display of hidden files. Voila, there you are. It's grayed out as it's a hidden directory, but it's there. And so is a boot file for DOS and even the usual suspects config.sys and autoexec.bat. Inspecting deeper into the MS-DOS 7 folder, you'll find the usual suspects.
So did Microsoft include MS-DOS 7 in Windows 2000 after all?
Nah, not really. I inspected Windows 2000's i386 folder and the files contained therein very thoroughly, but I couldn't find any of the DOS files in there. So it must be files that were coming from Windows 98 and just being relocated to the MS-DOS 7 folder during the upgrade process. To support that claim, I was looking into the upgrade directories beneath the i386 folder. In there, there's a bunch of files required for the Win9X upgrade and migration procedures, more specifically this one, the migrate.dll file. Just doing a simple string dump already reveals interesting bits, like the DOSMIC aligned statement, a reference to MS-DOS 7, and here, an entire section naming the typical DOS files. There's also this micdb.inf file, which makes many references to the old DOS files. So when installing Windows 2000 from scratch, you'd never end up having MS-DOS 7 on your hard drive. That's definitely something only happening when upgrading from Win9X.
Would that include Windows ME as well?
Well, let's see. But first I want to know what this obscure MS-DOS 7 looks like. According to the Microsoft Knowledge Base article, there should be a boot option available to divert into MS-DOS 7. Though, when pressing F8 to bring up the boot menu, there's no such option in sight. That's odd. So I was going back into Windows 2000, inspecting the files on the hard drive again. So there's this file, bootsec.dos, and I see also msdos.sys and io.sys. So I'll simply go by editing boot.ini myself, adding another clause to boot MS-DOS 7. Alright, so now I have the boot option, let's see if it works. Ha! You see, we're booted into MS-DOS now, and it's giving me some hints that my original config.sys and autoexec.bat files are found beneath the MS-DOS 7 directory. According to the KB entry, this DOS should now report as MS-DOS 7. But nope, it still reports as Windows 98. So the installer definitely neither got the DOS files from elsewhere, but from the previous Windows 98 itself. And although I had somewhat hope for it, it didn't apply any patches to replace the Windows 98 strings by MS-DOS 7 strings.
So why does the knowledge base entry then say different?
I don't know. Maybe the article was written before the actual implementation, or the documentation team was not in sync with the developers. It's also possible that this goes back to the initial plans of Microsoft. Originally, they wanted to merge the consumer and business operating systems already with Windows 2000. But the idea was scrapped, leading both to an unexpected intermediate release of the Win9X line going by the name of Windows ME or Millennium Edition. Said merger finally only came in 2001 with the very successful Windows XP. So it's well possible the MS-DOS 7 folder is a relic of those original intentions, planning to provide some DOS compatibility besides Windows 2000. Anyways, that's not the only thing where reality seems to divert from the documentation, as the latter also mentions some batch files to be existing in the MS-DOS 7 folder, which clearly aren't there. Plus, the weird thing that it claims, there should be a boot entry where in fact, there is not. And another strange thing is that the Windows 98 defrag.exe was copied over, although that totally doesn't make any sense as you can't run it from DOS itself. And trying to run it from Windows 2000 throws errors as defrag is requiring direct disk access, something which is prohibited by the Windows 2000 architectural design. Now, I was suspecting that the missing boot menu entry could simply be an error coming from the fact that I ran this on the German localized copies of Windows. So I went to repeat the entire procedure with the English versions of Windows 98 and Windows 2000. But it was rather disappointing to again find the MS-DOS 7 files, but not the actual boot entry. And this was not patched in any way either, and still reports as Windows 98 as well. To add to this, I tried both the Windows 2000 original RTM version, but also a later SP4 version, not making any difference on the actual outcome. But maybe an earlier beta version would show something more. But the pre-beta version doesn't offer yet an upgrade installer, and so does beta 1. Beta 2 bails out with an error quite early on, even when trying to run winnt32.exe manually. Beta 3 failed early on as well when trying to copy the Microsoft Foundation classes, but at least could create the upgrade report. Only RC1 was then progressing through the installer, though it didn't hang indefinitely during the first reboot. Maybe I should try switching to PCM and try it again. Anyway, RC2 finally did what it should, and look here, it has the MS-DOS boot option right away without the need for tampering around with the boot.ini file. Although it doesn't have the various batch files which were mentioned on the knowledge base and also no rebranded version string, it remains a mystery why the boot entry was dropped from the final release of Windows 2000.
But what about Windows Me now?
I'm not sure this works, as officially upgrading from Windows Me to Windows 2000 is not supported. But you can trick the Windows 2000 setup into running by first deleting these files from the /windows/setup directory. At least it starts, though I'm not having high hopes after all. Okay, we ended up again with the MS-DOS 7 folder, even though the version of DOS that came with Windows Me is strictly speaking MS-DOS 8. No surprise, it's missing again from boot.ini, so let's fix that. Interestingly enough, it boots, though clearly identifying itself as Windows Millennium. Plus, I see this error about the missing vmm32.vxt. And the prompt I have is not really a DOS prompt, but just asking me for the file. Let's see what happens if I point it to command.com. Okay, it locks up. Now, that's exactly what I expected, as this is symptomatic for the real mode functionality being absent from MS-DOS 8. Now, this again proves my earlier statement that Windows 2000 didn't include MS-DOS 7 by itself, but extracts it out from Win9X during the upgrade. It remains to say that the MS-DOS 7 folder seems to be somewhat obscure and probably a relic from before Microsoft dumped their then current plans to have Windows 2000 become the OS to succeed both the consumer and business operating system series. What's your opinion of it? Let me know in the comments below. I'm the Vintage Collector and this was my story for today. Thanks for watching and see you again next Sunday. Next time on the Vintage Collector. Microsoft did everything to hide away MS-DOS from Windows Me, even stripping away DOS real mode support. But there's ways to uncover MS-DOS 8 and make it somewhat functional again.